Joining me now is angel parent Melanie Kortling. Melanie, thank you for being here. It's tragedy that you're here to talk about this. I'm unhappy that you're here to talk about this. I'm thankful that you're here to highlight the problem. I don't know how a parent goes on. Your 22-year-old was taken away from you 13 years ago.
Yes.
How do you go on when you know in the back of your mind what I just said, is that your daughter should be alive today were it not for an illegal?
Absolutely, she should be here. If he had not kept coming back into this country, Amy would still be here.
And you said kept coming back. In other words, this person has been deported or had been deported?
Yes. This was his fifth DUI conviction. He had three previous deportations, formally deported. His fourth DUI conviction, he spent a year in jail here and was deported formally and came back 6 months later to kill my daughter.
And where is he now? Do you know?
Yeah, he's sitting on the border over there in Calexico. I believe it's Sentinella. Mm-hmm. I keep a watchful eye on
in
where,
jail?
Yeah, in prison, state prison, yes. He is, they settled with second-degree murder, serving 21 years to life, a mandatory 21 years before he can even become eligible for parole.
We're 13 years later now, right?
13 years
so
now.
So this guy could be out of prison relatively soon.
Yes. I mean,
we're talking 7 years or so.
Yes, right? Absolutely.
Now, what goes through your mind now that your daughter is not here? She was killed at a tender age of, what,
22.
Yeah, this guy in 7 years or so could be walking the streets.
He will be. That's my biggest fear. You know, is he will get out, and if he is deported, he'll be back. He will come back, and this is where my job as a parent comes in to bring awareness to this and to stop him from coming back in again and taking another baby.
Well, there's got to be another way, a better way, right? Than just simply walking this guy out of jail and hoping and praying that he doesn't breach our sovereign border again, right?
Right.
There's got to be a way to protect our border. So you are in favor of what the president is trying to do?
Absolutely. Absolutely. He promised us angel families that our babies will not have died in vain. He will secure this border. This wall is being built as we speak, and I have all the faith in the world in our president that he's going to look out. He is looking out for our best interests, for the interests and the safety and well-being of our children and our loved ones.
And you've got so much faith in him that you went to Washington, D.C.
Yes,
recently.
I did.
From San Diego County, you went to Washington, D.C., and you lobbied Congress, and you tried to get the attention of the president, correct?
Yes. We were kept from the president's knowledge of knowing that we were in town because they were afraid that if we got to him, we did not want him signing that bill. And they were afraid that if we got to him, the man has a heart.
Right.
You know, I mean, he's shed tears with us.
Who kept you from the president?
His staff, the White House staff.
They didn't want you to tell the president about what you've been through,
no.
Your trials and tribulations?
They didn't want us to get to him and soften his heart so to stop him from signing that bill.
It's a tragedy.
Major.
On the other hand, you knocked on Nancy Pelosi's door also, right? But you had a different greeting there.
Yeah, we were mad. She called the police on us.
Right.
We were parents were in her office. We just want her to be a woman and a mother. As a mother, come out and speak with us. Hear our voices. This is not manufactured. These tragedies, the beautiful lives stolen away. We just want to speak to her.
She calls it a manufactured crisis.
She does.
What do you call it?
This is reality. This is our reality. This is a nightmare is what it is.
And so Nancy Pelosi represents a district in California, not your district.
Right.
I would imagine, thank goodness.
Thank goodness.
Yet still in California, you live in California. What's it like living in California and knowing that you almost are working with the enemy, if you will? You have a woman like Nancy Pelosi, and the majority, the representatives in California now, are Democrats that walk lock, stock, and barrel behind Nancy Pelosi. They're against securing this border. How do you survive in California knowing all that?
I am a native San Diegan, born and raised here. I said it in Washington, D.C. I'm ashamed to admit that I am from the state of California. It's humiliating. It's an embarrassment. They have given away our country to the illegals, and they don't live in a reality that we here live in by living on a border.
They don't see it.
They don't see it.
They've
got drivers that drive them around. They have walls around their homes. Right. They're oblivious. They have no clue what it's like living in the real world.